Yes, family, welcome back to the channel. So as promised, yeah man, we're gonna build an outdoor pit grill. Alright. So right now I have it laid out. How I want it set up right now, the concept. So this is not actually finished yet. So what I got is I gotta dig down a little bit into the ground. I cover the base with some sand, and then what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna build the bricks up. Alright, so it's gonna probably be about that normal grill light, you know. And then as you can see, this is from one of my older grills, and one of the grills I'm gonna build a long time ago. So I figured somebody could have used that tapia instead, right? So what I'm gonna do now, if you can see, the bug them out here enough today. Alright. So once we get this thing built, I'm gonna put 2x4 around the edge. Then I'm gonna nail it down in the back. So see it already have the chimney. I have my temperature gauge already on it. As I said, it was a previous grill I'm gonna build. So when you open it now, it's gonna look like that on the inside, right? And I'm gonna drop a little thing for hold it down so it not fall over to the back, you know. But this is gonna definitely be deeper. Alright. So first thing what we need to do, just gonna mark it wrong. Alright, so we're gonna dig, got a mark on the edge. More mark it a little bit bigger than the actual space, you know? So that is it. So, next what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna remove all of these, and I'm gonna dig it out, all right? So, yeah man, I'm gonna stay tuned to the project, you know? You don't know, jack of all trades, master of none, right? So, first time I build something like this, all right? So, I'm gonna stay tuned. All right, let's get this thing started. And the bugs are out. Today. I can reuse this grass too. Good thing. I got some empty spots in the yard, so be my little sod pile, you know? Can do anything when you have the right tools, you know? You know what might be here? Tree stump. A lot of trees over here where I cut them down. Definitely a tree stump, tree root. top. Big tree stump. It's gonna be the hardest part of my job. Back-breaking work right here. Woo-wee. Sand in this bad boy. Don't need to dig down any further than that. Just need a layer. Just drop the sand in. So now we've got everything flattened out. We're just gonna mark our around our grill. Little guy. Same time, I'm getting some rust. Rust popped off the grill. See? Smarter, not harder. So that way I don't have to repaint the grill. Separate. Alright. Let that dry a little bit. We're going to go ahead and start setting up our bricks. All right, so we have it the width we want. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna just lay out the bricks then. I mean, I do it a different way than you normally see it. What I'm gonna do is leave some space in between there. So that way, cement tonight. That part is done. What I'm gonna do is gonna put the edges around there and drop in the cement. Alright, so stay tuned. Alright, so I'm gonna try another way that I've seen it done. So one thing I'm doing, I'm just gonna block these little areas where the cement seep out. In all these little spaces. There's multiple ways you can do this. I'm gonna try this one. Alright. So, as you can see, I blocked all the little crevices. Alright, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna pour the cement in there, okay? And then once I pour the cement in there, then I'm gonna wet it, let it dry. Alright, so that's my auto frame. So that right there is good to go. And the cement is gonna fill all these cracks. We're gonna wet it and we're gonna let it dry. Alright? So, it's my experiment. Alright, so let's see how it goes. Alright, stay tuned. Alright, so we're gonna build a frame for the vent. So there'll be two vents on the side for air and then one in the front so we can put logs in the fire. Or put the start fire. So I'm gonna cut this up real quick. I guess I need to plug it in, huh? Thanks, Lynn. Oh, I didn't tell y'all, I saw this giant snake in my shed. So I'm shook right now. I can't even think straight. Twice I encountered him. But hopefully he leaves. Because I'm not going back in there. It's his shed now.
I
just had it. Did you take my tape measure, man?
I got it.
See, I knew it was somewhere. What did I say? Five? 5 inches?
Mm-hmm.
My frame, so that way when I get ready to build my opening, this will be my opening where I can put my lumber on. All right, so it'll sit like that. I'll frame over it with bricks. Of course, I gotta put some screws in here to make sure it stays tight, and that way I can feed my lumber in there. Alright, so I gotta build two more of these. But that'd be it. Alright, so stay tuned. Alright, family, so got the bricks laid down. Alright, so what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna fill the gaps with cement. Some with this thing so I can make the bag a little bit lighter. Right.
side. So what we're going to do, spread it out, a little brush.
Get all these cracks filled in.
Alright, all the extra stuff put back in the bag.
Never tried this before. This is the kind of the easiest way to get your base down. You know what I'm saying? So then everything else we're gonna build up. So alright, so now get the hose. Just gonna sprinkle this. Some of that water soaking a little bit. All That's it. Now let this dry today, and then we'll come back tomorrow, check it out, see how it's looking. We'll be good to go. All right, so that's it for the day. Yeah, we're gonna let this dry, and then tomorrow we'll come back and check on it and start working on the build up. All right, so stay tuned till tomorrow.